A good battling game, if you ask me, that you can ever find on the Android market or App Store, wherever. It has been a pretty much combination of world skill trainers. With the pretty graphics and very good battling. Yeah. So let's come to the gameplay. The second one is a battle mode, the third is faction wars. If you go into the battle mode, here this thing is like a career. So you know, Real Racing 3, there are multiplayer games and career gear racing games. So in the same wise, if you go into the battle mode, here you see a career mode where you can fight. You can fight with in-app challenges and gain more experience and increase your rewards. So the best thing about the game, coming to the game, the best thing about here is winning the battles gives you more damage points and health points and accuracy points. So you don't have to spend much money on upgrading and all. Going to the store buying coins and gold coins or something like that. You don't have to do it much. You can also increase it manually by competing with players. Like you can see, your health for much of 278, but when you start the game, it will be in 200. So if you go on fighting with your opponents, these health points, accuracy points and damaging points keeps on increasing. So that's kind of a benefit over here. So in battle mode, you will be playing with offline opponents where you can increase your experience points and come to the challenging mode where it is totally online. You can participate in winning and get these and keep going your getting your experience points, it becomes easy as well. So the third one we have is faction wars, where you will battle other players online, like multiplayer online. Here is the faction wars is the place where you can earn some equipment, some rewards greater than this battle mode and challenging mode. Coming to the gameplay, I'm gonna show you one among this. Let's say I'll take up so here it says I'm gonna have 10,000 reward if I fight 12 matches among all these players. So don't expect it to be easy, because obviously they will have high damaging point, high accuracy points and high health points, as you can see here. So I'll give it a shot. Since I haven't made much in my career progress, that is in the battle mode, I don't have much experience points too. Still can give it a chance, so there's nothing wrong. Even if you lose, there's nothing you're gonna lose in actually. You'll gain some experience point or health points or damaging point, whatever. Yeah, he is pretty quick now. So while you can just go and slamming your opponents, the game gives you some tricks. You can see it will ask you to keep fighting here and over there, and it gives you some extra moments. and yeah, that's an additional I can say empowering. So it is being empowering when the best British shot because he has high damage points. But need not worry, since you are playing against an opponent, it can be pretty easy. It's not like exactly it's going to be totally online. It's a stored data of some other players. So if you click on the bottom left corner, you can see a dice like thing. If you press it, you will have an extra, an extra power of hitting your opponent. So the best thing to avoid getting hit brutally is that you have an option here to block, for which you have to hold down your both the thumbs on the screen so he will block. Yeah, you can see over here I just hold down my two thumbs on the screen, two thumbs or whatever, you can just hold down it on the screen with your any two fingers and it will give a block. Even if you lose in any match, it's not gonna harm you to match extent. You can see over here, with one person, if you play correctly, without giving them any chance of hitting you back again and again, you can easily win. So here you can see I have just won the game, and all my things have just leveled up. You can see the damage has increased by 45, 42, 42 for three different players, and health points 36, 38 and 46, and shield points 40, 40 and 46, and extra shield and extra empowerment points were 40, 40 and 42. Yeah, this is how you can keep leveling up. So you don't have to worry about gaining points and increasing. You can also increase manually, it's not a big deal. Just go and type on the player you wanna, to whom your points you wanna give extra abilities. So you can see here it was 408 and it's 453 now for Shirai Ryu. It was in 300s and now it's 420 for Saurian. Yeah, similarly it was 358 for Sergeant and it's now 420. So you can see now winning the matches over here increases the player's ability, I mean your team's ability. So you can select particular team, you can add more cards over here. For now I have only these many, so even if I type on any three teams, it will just show me these three cards. So because I have only three, so I'll just go on to Shirai Ryu to upgrade him manually. So this is how you can do. You just have to click on what you have to upgrade manually. So I'm going to upgrade his kunai abilities. Here you can see minimum kunai attack, medium damage. So medium damage health points are 108 to 117 and maximum damages are 217 to 235. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click on buy. Oops, sorry guys, sorry for the disturbance. Anyways, yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and click on buy. You can see now it has increased. So this is how you can also purchase manually, or you can upgrade it to any of your team member. And here you have some kind of equipments. As I have told you, to gain this equipments you have to go into the faction wars. So I'll be showing you. So now I have shown you the challenging mode. So in the battle mode also, it is equally same in the battle mode. You'll gain some experience points as you go on winning the matches. It's like a career thing. See, you can see here I have already destroyed these two towers. Tower for you are entering a new tower, any progress you have made. So I have already completed it. If I wanna do it again also I can do it, but the progress I have already made in the tower will be erased by your new progress. So that's not a problem, because you can keep increasing your experience points and etc etc. So go ahead and click cancel. So this is what you can do in the battle mode, it is also always equally same. Since I don't have much time, I'm not gonna show you how it is this. It's the same thing as in the challenging mode. So let's come into the faction wars. So here you can join any faction like Black Dragon, Brotherhood of Shadow, Lin Kyo's Special Forces, White Lotus, anything, whatever you want, you can just go ahead and choose it. It is also like a career mode, but the thing here is you'll get an extra rewards and extra equipments that will help you in other battles. Then you can go ahead and choose anything. You can also come back later and choose the another mode. So I'm just gonna go ahead with Black Dragon. So it's gonna load the game data. So once it has loaded, you can see select your fight alone. You have only option of fighting alone. So I'm gonna go ahead and choose Shirai Ryu because he has high damage point, highest accuracy, and a bit lower health points, but damage points are what it counts here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and click on Shirai Ryu. It asked me to equip, since I have obtained a level up card. You can also get this from extra rewards if you keep playing daily. I'm just gonna go and level this up. So now that's how I can do it. I'm gonna go back. Once you gain equipments, it will be available here. You can just select them and click on equip. So what I have here is Bloodstone Ring. Okay, fine, I'm gonna equip it. 32% resistance to poison, accessory, yeah, that's it. So that's all you have in faction wars. Now you can go on the leaderboard, edit team, and just fight along quick battle. So here you have the team. This is like I have told you, this is like an online thing. I'm just gonna go ahead and show you. The only thing here is I have told you already, you can bring an extra thing. You just have to be quick that and you shouldn't give any chance to your opponents. If they get chance, they will be ramming you in the same way. And do not forget, once it starts hitting you, taking your ass off, all you have to do is just hold down, just implement your block by holding down any two fingers on your screen. Once your extra power charges up on the left to bottom, you just have to click it and rotate it, and it will implement an extra power. Yeah, that's a victory for me now. Yeah, that's how you have to do in faction wars. It always gives you an extra reward. You can see over here. I have got 330 gold coins, 600 extra ability points, and war points about 100. I'm gonna go ahead and click next, and that's it. So this is how you have to get into the factional wars. So for now, I'm gonna cancel it as it is just a tutorial. Yeah, so that's it. And then now you can see a soldier, a round color soldier symbol over here. If you just click on it, here you can have your extra rewards sent by your friends. The another thing in this game is that your team will be hired by some other players to help them. So once you go and help them, you'll be awarded with rewards. So here you can see your champion has been used. Claim your rewards, because one of my team members has been used. I have got some rewards. I'm gonna go ahead and accept it. So let's see what rewards I have got. There are 100 ally points, so I'm gonna go and add that to Cullen's. You can see now it has increased to 450. So you can do in this. You can also add all this manually from the Play Store. for a certain amount of money, but I don't recommend you that because you don't have to do that, because everything here you can gain simply by matches. So this money is not needed unless you want to go and upgrade your team for extra abilities to keep competing in the challenging mode or faction modes. But then I would prefer you to, if you want to keep on winning things, I would prefer you to just go into the faction wars and join any team and select your background and just go on winning the coins, make it 1,000. Once you reach 1,000 over here, you'll get an extra equipment and extra gold ally points and you can see the scroll symbol which gives you extra reward points. So that's it guys, I hope this video has helped you, and this video will give you an extra knowledge of how to make a quick progress through the game. Let me see, here this menu is not much needed, or it's not compared to the game, it's all about graphic and video settings. So this is about the game. I hope you have liked the video, and if it is so, please subscribe and encourage me to give you more video game tips and tricks. You can check into my channel about how to hack this game and also other games, and tips and tricks about how to win online battles and all in other games. Thanks guys, thank you for watching. Farewell, and please don't forget to subscribe.